Hey,
go get me some links. Yeah, we talking about breakfast.
Hey,
breakfast with the links, and we drinking out the sink.
Hey,
and the week.
Hey, we got the links on now.
Hey, topic. Hey. Now we talking about the shoes. We talking about the shoes. Pay attention to the rules. Okay, now we going off of different dudes.
I don't know.
6.6.
Oh, man. Ronnie on the track.
So for Cop Watch and Red, we talked about how to film the police, things to keep in mind, things to not do, why filming the police is important for us. And then we talked about the last session, the alternative policing. We started talking, a lot of people had a lot of knowledge on what kind of things we should be thinking about when we talk about police and safe communities, how we build communities without the police, and what that might take, what that might look like. So with all those things in mind, like, when we break out into sessions, we're going to talk about why those various things are important, and like we want to hear from y'all, like how would we present these issues?
I think that like the fact that somebody who recorded something so brutal and something that needs to be seen and something that is, you know, that video justifies how brutal the cop was, you know what I'm saying? If that's evidence to prove against the justice system, then, you know, then there shouldn't be a problem. But because, you know, there is this sort of like, you know, on this system, then it becomes a crime now to just, you know, bring to light the bad things that's been going on.
Well, I feel like your safety is at stake because, like, if you're too close, like, there's no telling what the cop could do to you.
How do we reboot the whole system? What is the new system look like? What is it really based on?
I think it should be more based on community.
Community.
Because it's like all these laws are set in place for community. So my politicians are never going to do it. So it's like stuff needs to be like identified within the community and then taken into the hands of the people in there. And then it's like, okay, what do we do to move forward and fix them? No one's born a bad person, so it's not like you're born evil, so you should be sent to prison. It's just like, okay. Because in prison, they send you there, and it's supposed to, it's a detention center, but that's really all it is. Like, it's not teaching you to fix what you've done or give you a different mindset. So, like, creating a space for people that have made mistakes, instead of calling them criminals, people that have made mistakes, like give them a space to identify those mistakes and fix them and like prevent them from happening again.
CPD is saying.
If you had 15 minutes to present to the world an issue like Know Your Rights, why is that important? How would you present that?
Like in a powerful way?
Mm-hmm.
I say poetry, no lie. You know, my specialty is on rap, so you know.
Rap is rhythm and poetry, so you got this, bro.
So in that, so.
Nope. A skit. This can't work so skit. A skit. Yeah. That would be popping.
Skit. What would be in the skit though? Like acting out.
Like a police officer coming.
Police brutality.
Death is on every garden. Money is the reason why the police are getting in trouble. They watch us 24/7. And why can't we watch them?
How, even though sometimes the cop watching doesn't totally eliminate the unjust system that we live in, it still brings to light the cruelty that and the injustice that the police force put on people of color. And then we listed ways in which we could combat that through our art. So we thought of, you know, like doing public plays, like we did public performances. I thought of like a flash mob at the police station or something like that.
Alternatives to the justice system. Yeah, so basically we started off by listing like what the current system was like, and it's a slavery-based system. So we thought for an alternative system we could have a community-based system. And then we thought of, instead of police, it should be like a tightly knit community that has members that have different roles, so that everyone's like working together to prevent things from like that like police would have to deal with from happening. So that was.
I just came from the poetry room and I was recording them talking about like stuff about terrorists and how America is terrorist. Like, I think that's what they said. But they was talking about like people just now noticing this kind of stuff is happening. Like, I don't even know what kind of stuff they was talking about, but I heard the word terrorist in America a lot.
What's one thing that like really caught your attention that like really, other than that, if you can't remember?
That's really it, because that's the only thing I could tell you about. I don't know. I gotta look back at the tape.
Did it make you want to like learn more about the situation, or like what like brought it to the surface at all?
No. No, it didn't.
Were you aware of like the issue as far as like terrorists in America and how Americans view Muslim and Arabic people at all?
Nope. Not up in America, nope.
Real foul. How they dehumanize and depict these people, like based on one group's like decisions to carry out God's work, in a sense, I guess. Even though that's what Americans have been doing since the beginning of the time. So.